If you're traveling to Tokyo for the first time, there is a very good chance that you will be making this mistake, and you won't be the only one, because I was definitely very much guilty of it myself when I came here for the first time. So picture this. For some reason, you find yourself back in one of your favorite cities on Earth. You go out for a stroll without any particular destination in mind. You get yourself a nice cup of matcha, and then you find this. Like, I cannot even believe it. Pink flowers in Tokyo. And I'm saying pink flowers on purpose because I'm not 100% positive if it's sakura or not, if it's cherry blossom. It might be plum, because I heard that plum blossoms before cherry, and we are 3 weeks before cherry blossom season. When planning a trip, especially to a place like Tokyo where there is so much to do and see, we tend to overfill our schedule, plan way too much ahead of time, and then rush from one place to another, checking things off like it's some sort of a job.
I feel like we have all had that experience before of going on a trip and then coming back home even more tired than we were before. At least I have had that experience many times before. And you know why it happens so often when we travel? It happens because we put too much pressure on ourselves to experience it all, to do it all.
So on this trip to Tokyo, I decided that things will be different. I am not coming home tired. I won't be repeating my own mistakes. And I decided to give myself a bit of a challenge, spending 48 hours in Tokyo without a plan and focusing on truly enjoying this incredible city to the fullest. And most important of all, making sure that I will have as many beautiful, unexpected experiences like this one. Finding an early bloomer or plum tree on a random little street by Yoyogi Park, whatever it was beautiful. And it kind of reminded me that some of the best things in life happen to us when we expect them the least, or where we just let life do its thing and allow a little magic to happen.
And here is how I am planning to explore Tokyo. So on this trip, I will be connecting to Tokyo Free Wi-Fi, which is basically this free service provided by Tokyo Metropolitan Government for all tourists coming to Japan, just to make our life easier. There are over 7,000 spots like this one all over Tokyo, all over major tourist attraction stations, everywhere basically, where you can just connect to the internet for free. All you have to do is put your email and it's done. And then basically wherever you go, your phone will just automatically connect to Tokyo Free Wi-Fi. Right now I'm a bit tired after the flight, to be honest, so I don't want to do much. Like, I want to take a chill. So I think what we're gonna do is that I want to see like a nice peaceful Japanese gardens. Obviously Tokyo, Japan are really known for beautiful gardens, and I haven't seen many last time I was here. Actually, I haven't seen any, so I just researched how to get there, and all I have to do is walk over to Harajuku Station and take the green Yamanote line. Also, pro tip, if you're coming to Tokyo for the first time, and especially if you don't have much time here, try to stay somewhere on the green Yamanote line, because it's one of the metro lines that covers pretty much all major tourist attractions in Tokyo. Like, some of the coolest neighborhoods that you will definitely want to see here, like Shinjuku, Shibuya, Harajuku, and also where I'm going right now. Just look at this view, how beautiful it is. So we are in Rikugien Garden, which is supposed to be one of the most beautiful gardens in Tokyo. And I figured that this would be the best way to start my trip. Being in nature just always puts me in a good mood, and I think it's a very good idea to combine a city break, a city trip, with as much time in nature as possible. And in Tokyo it is definitely very possible, because there are so many beautiful parks and gardens in this city. I don't know, there's just something about nature, right? Like, it keeps you grounded, it makes you happy. It is another beautiful day in Tokyo. It's literally beautiful. Look at the sky. It's blue, which makes me so happy. And you know what else makes me really happy every time I go out on the street in Japan? Just seeing Japanese convenience stores and knowing all the good things that they have in there. I mean, there's a very good reason why basically like everybody is crazy about Japanese convenience stores. They are very convenient and very good. So I just found a spot where I can connect to Tokyo free Wi-Fi. It's the tourist information map that you see behind me, and you have maps like this basically all over Tokyo where your phone just automatically connects. So that's great. Okay, so I'm gonna research now how to get to my next destination. I am going to Akasaka. It looks like all I have to do is to take Ginza line, so that's easy. Also, I know I will be getting hungry soon, so I'm gonna research onigiri shops in that area because I am really craving a onigiri. I just pull out my camera to say that I'm looking for that onigiri shop, and then I saw this mochi shop, so now I'm confused. Do I get an onigiri or do I get mochi, or do I get both? Maybe I just get both. Also, apparently I don't know how to pronounce mochi. So many people on the internet told me that I'm pronouncing it wrong, and I'm just like, how can you pronounce it wrong? It's such an easy word. Like, I don't know, like five letters. So I decided to go for onigiri because there is a pretty decent line. At least more than 10 people in the line for this onigiri shop. So must be good, so I'm gonna try it. And now, I just want to walk around and explore Akasaka. I have not been here before on my previous trip to Japan.
So as part of my no plan, no stress policy, just going with the flow and doing whatever I'm feeling in the moment, I basically just woke up this morning and thought to myself, let's see a cool district of Tokyo that I haven't been to before. So I chose Akasaka because I heard that it's apparently a really cool place, not as frequently visited by tourists, which is a shame because it definitely has a lot to offer. It's a bit more of a business district, at least parts of it, which also makes it more local. There are a lot of nice restaurants, shops here, but as I also found out, it's a great place to just walk around because it's not as crowded, and there's some really nice parks here and beautiful shrines.
As you can see, this is definitely very different to Shibuya, Shinjuku area. Definitely way less busy. I mean, less busy. There's still lots of people in the streets because it's still Tokyo, but it's definitely way more calm compared to like the main touristy spots of Tokyo. Whenever I say the name Tokyo, I want to sing this song, you know, that Tokyo, you got. So I came across this shrine, so I think I'm gonna go inside and check it out. But I just quickly wanted to show you this street, like how green it is. And we're still in central Tokyo, and that just blows my mind because that just proves the point that Tokyo is a very diverse city, which you could argue is a very obvious thing. A city of 30 million people will be diverse, but it really is diverse. I just found another spot where you can connect to Tokyo free Wi-Fi. and I'm currently researching other cool things that you can see in this area. And seeing that shrine kind of inspired me to research if there are any other temples or shrines that I should see here, because I did hear that this area is apparently known for it. And there's indeed a very nice one, like 500 meters from here. So I think I'm gonna go and check it out right now.
And look what we've got here. They even have like a mini version of Inari gates, like very similar to what you, for example, have in Kyoto.
Of course, not only in Kyoto, but you have them all over Japan. So Akasaka, you were great, and now I'm gonna head to another district that is quite nearby. It's kind of next to this district. It's called Shimbashi. I just found this phone booth. See? Phone booth. With Tokyo free Wi-Fi, so I'm connecting to the internet to research Shimbashi. What is Shinbashi known for? Oh, okay, so apparently it is known as a place where many Japanese salarymen go for a drink or food after work. And there's especially this famous place with lots of restaurants under elevated train tracks. So I want to check that out.
Oh, that looks really cool. Okay, I already like this. I think I found it. Must be somewhere there.
Okay, so I feel like there are two things that I could do with my life right now. Either I could go and eat sushi, because I have not had sushi yet in Japan. Not that I've been here that long, but I already had ramen like 3 times and no sushi, so... Or I could go to this viewpoint, because the weather is so nice that it would be nice to see the view of Tokyo from above. Two options are pretty good, so I don't know, maybe I'll just try to do both things. I love that they always give you these warm towels.
When I go traveling, I usually spend so much time planning everything out, so it was actually a very refreshing experience to see that when I just allowed myself to chill a little and take it easy and just explore whatever was in front of me, really, I still found so many cool places, and I honestly felt so inspired that day and just very alive. I was definitely having a very good time just wandering around these narrow alleys with local ramen shops and cool cafes and just going with the flow. But Tokyo is also one of these places where going with the flow is very much possible, because even though it might seem overwhelming at first because of its size and noise and all that, it is still a very easy city for tourists to explore. It's clean, it's safe, public transportation is super efficient, and also wherever you go, there will be something interesting to see.
The more I travel and also the older I become, the more I realize that it is actually so important to be open-minded and spontaneous and just let things be, just let life happen to you. And that's how you end up experiencing the best things in life. I had so much fun these last 2 days exploring Tokyo. And I guess I can officially say that this challenge was a great success. Let me know if you agree with me. I did end up seeing so many cool things, but then again, Tokyo is just one of these places that has so much to offer. Like, possibilities are just endless in this city, and even though it's such a big city, it's so easy and convenient to explore as a tourist. Like, I'm not even confused. I didn't even get lost once. Like, you know? I consider that a pretty great success. So I guess we could say that this challenge was very successful, because I did explore a lot. I saw so many cool things and I never got lost. So I hope you guys enjoyed hanging out in Tokyo with me. And what can I say? Until next time, Tokyo, because I can definitely say that there is gonna be next time, because I freaking love this city.